rose-colored glasses are off, it's time to get real. Yet, we remain hopeful still. This is the Marketing Disenchanted podcast. I am your host, Temitayo Osinubi. Let's get to it. Welcome to episode 000 of the Marketing Disenchanted podcast. We are going to start at the beginning and really get to know one another. Again, my name is Temitayo Osinubi, or Temi for short, and you're probably asking yourself, who is this person and why should I listen to him? Well, off the bat, unlike 99.99% of the actors in this space, I actually have a degree in internet marketing. Now, I know a lot of folks are going to have issues with that just off of principle. You got your Gary V's and a few other prominent digital marketers who don't think that you can learn this in a university setting, but just stick with me. I got an entire episode, the next episode, as a matter of fact, dedicated to some of the erroneous parts to that train of thought as someone who has gone through the process. I should also note that this is my second degree in digital marketing. The first one is from the School of Hard Knocks because I tried just Googling it. I started this journey way back in 2003, 2004. I was not looking forward to corporate life. I did not want a long commute, being forced around people I really didn't like. And more importantly, I was trying to get away from name discrimination. So real quick story, my ex, whom I have two beautiful children with, we used to joke that we started our relationship by me stalking her for 6 months, because at the time I was going to Sinclair Community College, majoring in civil construction and real estate investment. I wanted to be one of these people who fixed and flipped houses. So the shows on HGTV like Flip or Flop or The Property Brothers, that's basically what I wanted to do. And I was hell-bent on working at Lowe's Home Improvement. And at the time, she was the HR coordinator for Lowe's. And so one day at Sinclair, they had a job fair. And an HR from the Beaver Creek Lowe's was there, which I interviewed for, knocked it out the park. She said that she would refer me enthusiastically to the HR at the Dayton Mall, which is where I was trying to get hired. So I follow up that next day and nothing. So I continue to follow up every 2-3 weeks because I had been told by this other HR that I was a shoo-in and that she would refer me, but I just couldn't get anything. And it wasn't until the HR manager got fired and my ex was the acting HR that I finally got hired. And later on down the line, after we had started our relationship, she shared with me that the HR manager was the type that if she could not pronounce your name, she did not call you back. It did not matter what your qualifications were. It didn't matter what your resume said. If your name was anything other than Jim, Bob, or Tom, you were SOL. And so that is what led me to internet marketing in the first place. I was trying to get away from that type of scenario. And I ran headlong into network marketing, MLM, whatever you want to call it. I eventually found my way to Warrior Forum. And I got into info marketing and funnels and all that good stuff. And I bottomed out on all of it. And I actually hit rock bottom. I was doing penny clicks. Now, for those of you who don't know, penny clicks is the digital marketing equivalent of giving hand jobs at a truck stop. Like, you have officially bottomed out when you're doing penny clicks. And that's actually where I saw a banner ad for Full Sail, which is how I wound up in the degree program. What else? I'm also a millennial. I'm an older millennial. I was born in 84, so I'm right on the ass end of Gen X. So while, yes, I'm a digital native and I grew up with all of this stuff, I still remember the 80s. I was only 5, but I was there. And so I remember how things were before smartphones and gaming and all of this other stuff. So I have a very unique point of view, because oftentimes the people who talk at millennials, not necessarily to us, aren't millennials. Last but not least, before I move on, I'm also an author. So myself and a fellow Full Sail University grad, We decided to write a book taking a stance on structured education in digital marketing. It's called Beyond Buzzwords: Social Media, Mobile, and Other Marketing Buzzwords Ain't the Half of It. If you have not already, we invite you to check that out at thinkbeyondbuzzwords.com. It's a really awesome book, or at least I think so, because, you know, I wrote it. So, long story short, I say all of that to say that you are in very capable hands. I am eminently qualified to speak on the subject of digital marketing at length because, again, I hacked away at it for a decade before getting serious and getting a degree in it. And so I have a very unique point of view that precious few people can lay claim to. And so that is what I want to give to you in this podcast. So what is this podcast and why the name Marketing Disenchanted? Well, as I hinted at, when I first started this journey back in 2003, 2004, I was very naive. I was a true believer. Like, the internet changes everything. I don't have to have people delete my application just because of my name. I can just hop online, make money, and I'm good. And through my experiences, I quickly became disenchanted. But I still love this industry. I love everything about it, even warts and all. And but a lot of people don't really talk about what needs to be said plainly, right? There's a distinct lack of straight talk. There's a lot of fluff. There's a lot of, superfluous talk, but I don't think there's enough candid conversation about what it's really like to be a digital marketer. And I want to do candid conversations correctly, because I mentioned Gary Vaynerchuk previously, and while I don't agree with his stance on formal education, what I do like about Gary V is that he's really good at giving you that just kind of, you know, tough love medicine, saying things that may be unpopular but really need to be said. But you have to take care when being candid, because the opposite extreme of that is somebody like Donald Trump, right? Who just spews the first thing that comes out of his mouth, and consequences be damned, talking about grabbing women's crotches and whatnot. So I want to do candid conversations correctly about digital marketing. And so what this is really about is, like I said, I'm an older millennial. I'm 32 years old. I'm really talking to my 22-year-old self, right? So if I knew then what I know now, right? Because I'm still young. I'm only 32 years old, born 1984, but I'm fresh out of 20s, right? My 20s are all gone. I officially have a misspent youth. And so I'm doing my best to try to rectify that and pass on any nuggets that I've gained over the years. And so, yeah, that's the quick rundown. That's myself. That's what this podcast is about. And we're going to take a short break, and then we're going to get right into what I call my disenchanted definition of marketing. In the last 3 months of the 2016 U.S. presidential election, fake news outperformed real news on Facebook. Now, don't worry. This is a podcast about marketing, not politics. But what I'm trying to pull out with that example is that most people can't call BS online when they see it. Now, this is in stark contrast to the whole un-college movement that favors finding information online, oftentimes for free, as opposed to paying for higher education. Now, that tactic can work, assuming you can call BS when you see it, which unfortunately most people just can't. The ability to call BS online, what we call digital discernment, is a skill, which means that it can be learned. Go to bit.ly.com/DMD course to learn the skill of digital discernment. In this short course, taught by yours truly, I condense my over a decade of trial and error experience, as well as the skill I learned getting a degree in digital marketing, for your benefit. Go to bit.ly.com/DMD course right now. That's bit.ly/D as in dog, M as in Mary, D as in dog course. All right, so what follows is my disenchanted definition of marketing. That's right. This is my podcast, so I have my own definition of marketing. You're not going to find this in any textbook because it's not PC. but it's as true a definition as you're going to get. So, marketing is mass behavior modification that produces a consistent business outcome. One more time. Mass behavior modification that produces a consistent business outcome. And we are going to take that point by point. So, first one, mass. What do I mean by that? It means you use a form of mass communication. So it's one to many. You're using the internet, social media, podcasts. If you want to go old school, television, radio, newspaper. But the form of communication that you're using is one to many. So you're using mass media. And this is where it gets tricky because it's not PC. You got to be real careful when you say behavior modification because people freak out on you. They get all big brother and start wearing tinfoil hats and because they're worried about mind control and all that nonsense. But the reason I say behavior modification is because nobody comes out the womb a consumer, right? Nobody is born thinking that this sugary bottle of candy is synonymous with Christmas and polar bears. Shout out to Coca-Cola, by the way. Yes, I know I just took a shot at you, but I did it for shock value and just to really emphasize how good marketing can modify one's behavior. Because people think holidays, people think Coke, right? That didn't just happen that way. That got introduced to us via marketing and reinforced every single year. And I don't even like Coke because this study has been done time and time again, and it proves they do a blind taste test, and 50% of people like the flavor of Pepsi and 50% of people like the flavor of Coke. But if you ask them which one they prefer, 70% of people will say Coke. Now, the 20% that said Coke but chose Pepsi, they're not lying. They're not being intentionally dishonest, but that's the power of Coke's brand. That behavior modification will override what you can prove to people. Because I can prove to you that you actually like Pepsi, but you'll still choose Coke, right? But it gets much deeper than blind taste tests, my friends. Oh, yes, it gets much, much deeper than that. This case study that I'm about to share, I learned in the degree program, and I will never forget this for as long as I live. So this guy goes into Target, and he is pissed off. He asks for the store manager, cusses the store manager out. He's like, my daughter is 16 years old, and you are sending her coupons for baby stuff. What the hell is wrong with you people? Are you trying to encourage my daughter to get pregnant? I mean, he just completely rips the store manager a new one. And the store manager, of course, apologizes like, hey, all of that stuff comes from corporate. We don't really deal with it here on the store level, but I'll make sure you're taken off the lift. I'm really apologize, blah, blah, blah. So next day, the guy comes back and he apologizes to the store manager. And he's like, you know, I guess there were some things going on in my house that I weren't fully aware of, and my daughter's due in a few months. So Target knew that this guy's daughter was pregnant before he did, because they were able to look at her shopping history. You know those Kroger Plus cards, those Target cards they give you? The reason you're a valued customer and they give you discounts is because they track everything that you buy. And they were able to deduce, this brilliant data scientist was able to deduce that based on her purchases, that not only was she pregnant, but she was in her third trimester of pregnancy. Now, that's freaky in and of itself, but that's not where the whole behavior modification thing comes in. The reason this is important to retailers is because market studies have shown that people really don't pay attention to advertising. We're creatures of habit, and we buy what we buy because that's our brand and that's what we buy, except during major life moments like having a baby or getting married or divorced or having somebody graduate from college or a kid moving out the house and now you're an empty nester. And shopping behaviors change in very interesting ways. Like, for example, when you get married, the types of cereal and toothpaste that you buy tends to change. And when you get a divorce, the brand of beer that you buy tends to change. Really interesting stuff. So as an advertiser, if you can catch people during these major life moments, you stand to have a consumer for a number of years. Because again, once that buying behavior gets locked in, it doesn't change until the next major life moment comes around. And so that's what I mean by behavior modification. I gave you the Coke example. I gave you the Target example. And last but not least, last part of the definition, produces a consistent business outcome. That's what we were just talking about. Any fool can make a sale once or twice, but successful brands want you to come back again and again. And that's where success comes in, because you can get people to purchase from you repeatedly. That's your cash flow. And so there you have it. Mass behavior modification that produces a consistent business outcome. That is the disenchanted definition of marketing. Again, you're not going to see that in any textbook. You're not going to hear that from anybody else. But again, from my over a decade of experience, as well as going through a degree program, I'm telling you, that's what marketing is. That's what it's about. Well, that's all for this, our very first episode. In the next episode, I am going to go into length about my experience getting a degree in internet marketing from Full Sail University, give you some pros, give you some cons, and again, give you the standpoint of someone who's actually gone through the process. Because a lot of these folks who have issues with digital marketing in college don't have degrees. So yeah, man, that's it. Have you ever been paralyzed while doing research? You go to Google, you type in your search query, and seconds later, you're hit with millions, if not billions, of search results, and you can't make heads or tails out of any of them. Overwhelmed and afraid you'll make the wrong choice, you don't make any choice at all. Well, friends, you're not alone, but you needn't suffer in silence. The ability to make sense out of what you find online, and more importantly, call BS when you see it, is a skill, which means that it can be learned. Go to bit.ly.com/DMD course right now to learn the skill of digital discernment. In this short course, taught by yours truly, I condense my over a decade of trial and error experience, as well as what I've learned getting a degree in internet marketing, for your benefit. Go to bit.ly.com/D as in dog, M as in Mary, D as in dog course. One more time, bit.ly.com/DMD course. Thank you for doing me the high honor of listening to the very end. Please subscribe in iTunes, Stitcher, or your favorite podcasting app. Leave a 5-star rating and write a review telling people about my unmitigated awesomeness. It really helps out with getting the show shown. Follow me on Twitter at Tembo8482. That's TEMB8482. Or connect on LinkedIn, and I'll have my LinkedIn description in the show notes. And I'll see you next week.